Thanks for staying with News at Prime tonight. A commission of inquiry into taxi industry violence will kick off next week. It was set up by Gauteng Premier David Makhura following a spate of killings across the province. Well, to tell us more about the commission and its work, the chair of that particular inquiry, Justice Jeremiah Buti, Shongwe, joining me now in studio. Thank you so much, Justice Shongwe, for your time tonight. You certainly sound like you have a mammoth task ahead of you. I've had a look at the terms of reference of this inquiry. It seems to cover anything and everything. So I wonder then, what frame of mind are you in going into it?
It is indeed a mammoth of a task that is before us. Well, we have been busy in the background trying to capacitate ourselves in terms of staff, in terms of researchers. Hence, we took some time before we started sitting. The frame of mind is the one that says you have to work, 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 and nothing else but work.
Let's take a look in particular at some of these terms of reference. The Premier wants you to investigate some of the underlying reasons for the recurring violence, to also look into the activities of operators, both legal and illegal, and it's not just confined to the taxi industry, to look at the provision of minibus transport services across the province, and how exactly this module of taxi buses has been set up in the province too. It sounds to me like all of these different terms of reference could themselves form an entire inquiry, given the scale of the business that you're talking about and the scale of the taxi industry. So how long are you expecting that your work is actually going to last? And I wonder then how you're going to be narrowing the work down for yourselves, or some of these issues, narrowing them down so that you do complete this inquiry sometime soon.
Indeed, the terms of reference are wide. Mm. However, we have to deal with them in such a way that we cover each and every aspect. We have lined up to how they do things. We have lined up people from the legislative authorities, the people who actually issue these operating permits. So once we have that information, together with information from the taxi operators themselves and from the commuters and from the public at large, we will have a picture as to what is the root cause of this violence. It is multi-pronged in the sense that it could be the routes that are given. Some people do not actually follow the routes which are authorized by the permit. And it could be some people who do not comply with the routes. It could be the authorities that issue the routes. Perhaps duplicating some of the routes. Why? We have to probe into that. And I hope that we will find our way through.
So from a legal perspective then, it sounds pretty clear to me that there are ways that you'll be able to tell where the fault lines, as it were, in the system are. I wonder though, because a lot of what happens also would be behind the scenes, would be unofficial, and you know, these terms of reference give you a scope to probe the legal and illegal activities.
Yes.
How important is the evidence that's going to be given by taxi operators themselves, which sometimes are forthcoming with it, doesn't harm their individual interests or even businesses?
True. The information that will be given by the taxi operators as well as the authorities will be very important in the sense that they know, each and every taxi operator knows which route has he or she been allocated. And in their daily work, they are quite aware as to who else is operating on that route, because they have what they call taxi associations. So people affiliate to taxi associations for a particular route they know themselves. And so the information that we will get from them will be very important, because it will tell us exactly what happens on the ground. We know what is happening in the taxi industry by reading newspapers and seeing news, but we'll be getting it from the horse's mouth, if I may say so.
There have been very few times where police have managed to, number one, find culprits and secure convictions that are directly responsible for some of the violence in the taxi industry. I wonder then if you will also be calling some of the state officials who've run some of these investigations to get insight from them, and how much of those waters you're willing to venture into.
Well, as you can see in the terms of reference, the commission is empowered to also investigate cases which have been reported. We have to find out how far have they gone with the investigation. We need to get case numbers. We need to get who the investigating officer is. We need to get to know the docket to take us through, so that we find out, has this case been finalized? If not, why not? If it has been finalized, we know what was the outcome. Now, for the information that we will get, we will have to bring to the fore in order to be able to suggest or make recommendations as to how that problem could be solved. But the other problem is there are allegations out there that some of the law enforcement agency members own taxes. Now, it complicates the whole picture, because there becomes a conflict of interest on their side. Now, for us to get that information, we need to follow exactly what happened to the case so that we can bring it forward.
You know, ultimately, you'll have to come to some kind of findings. Earlier, I asked you how long you're expecting this entire inquiry to run.
Yeah, the commission is proclaimed to run for 6 months. There have been delays. We are of the view that we might at some stage have to request the Premier to extend the period so that we are able to cover the whole work. But officially it is set for 6 months from the day of proclamation, 6 months thereafter.
As we have seen with other inquiries, and perhaps I'll reference the Zondo Commission of Inquiry here, there has been an issue of witnesses who are set to testify and who often the very nature of this inquiry you'll be holding is about violence. And, you know, unfortunately, there's a trail of bodies that who've lost their lives to that violence. Are you at all concerned about whether or not that will continue as the commission conducts its work? And have you had to take any additional measures to ensure, number one, the safety of those who you might be calling before you, but I think just to also stabilize the general environment of the taxi industry?
Indeed, we have. We have had meetings with the major taxi associations, Santaku, the GNTA, which operate mainly in Gauteng. Those questions have been raised. We have taken precautions. We have been in touch with the state security, with the law enforcement agencies, in a case where a person wishes to give evidence at a commission and fears for his or her life, so that we are able to arrange witness protection services so that they get protected. There has been a witness who gave evidence in camera. Issues of that nature have been taken care of should a need arise, because we will take case by case. We have to know what kind of information does the person have. The investigators as well as the evidence leaders have to interrogate that before, and the commission will have to decide then whether this is a deserving case where a person should be, his or her evidence be heard in camera.
Do you have any reason to believe, though, that there would be any increased incidents or nature violence where this inquiry is concerned?
In the contrary, we have reasons to believe that once the commission kicks off, sits formally, the violence will die down, because people believe that it will be an avenue through which they will be able to put their complaints, put their stories, and the commission will take care of them. So far, we have had good news about the commission, that people have confidence in it even before it starts, because they believe it is going to resolve their issues.
And to the extent that some of the battles that we might see play themselves out in Gauteng may not even originate from this province, but may have links to other provinces, how are you going to be making sure that your investigation is able to really trace the problem down to its root, where the need may arise?
This commission has been constituted to deal with the Gauteng province, with issues arising from the taxi violence in the Gauteng province. We will receive evidence from the operators, from the commuters, from the law enforcement agencies, even from people who are outside the country, I mean outside the Gauteng, as long as the issues relate to Gauteng. The information will direct us as to where to start and where to stop.
All right. Let me thank you for your time and coming in to explain all of that to us. We certainly wish you all the best as you kick off then with this particular commission of inquiry. Justice Jeremiah Buti Shongwe, he is, of course, the commissioner that's going to be heading up the special inquiry looking at taxi violence, particularly in Gauteng. We're going to take a short break. I'm back with your headlines in a moment. Do stay with us.